Hello Kronvik fans, hello Ford fans. Today I want to show you my last video for this year. It's mid of November and the winter is coming up with fast steps, and that is the proof that I need a cap and some gloves. So it's a little bit cold today. Yeah, why is the last video, or why is that the last video for this year? As I mentioned, it's mid of November and next week I've got a shoulder surgery, and I think then I will be out of order for a few weeks, and I can't drive with my car. And so today is the last possibility to go to the Ford dealer here, and today I will explain you a little bit the differences between ordering a car in the US, buying a car in the US versus buying a car in Germany. And I also want to show you the models you can get, the Ford models you can get in Germany versus the Ford models you can buy in the US. So let's start with this nice sign in the background. And while we are going to the cars here, I show you, or I explain you a little bit about the main differences of buying a car in Germany versus US. So I'm here at a mid-sized Ford dealer in Germany. It's not a little one, but it's also not a big one. And the main difference in Germany, if you ordering a car, is that you haven't so many cars ready to buy at your preferred dealer. You have to order it and you have to wait. Yeah, and you have to wait from 3 months up to 1 year if you get your ordered car. And I think it's the main difference between US and Germany. I know in the US you have huge parking lots at your favorite dealer, and you go into the dealer and ask to the sales attendant, and maybe you have three lines if you want to buy a Ford Focus. Maybe it's a basic line, a mid-size line, and a premium line, and you decide what you want, you pay all your finance, you take your car and go out. Yeah, that's in the US. But if you are in Germany, you have a catalog where you can order everything in every or nearly every combination you want. It's called free options, and there are some things like what kind of stereo you want, what kind of color the seats, outside color, do you want heated seats or not, do you want some assistance or not, how many airbags do you want, do you want a sunroof or not, do you want to take a trailer or not, many other things. Yeah, if you buy maybe a luxury car, there can be 100 or more options. Yeah, and then you decide what you want to order and what you want to pay, and the car dealer will order the car for you, and then you have to wait many months. Yeah, so I can I talk with experience to you, because I've ordered a few years ago the Volkswagen Tiguan. It was a brand new on the market. I waited 12 months to get this car. Yeah, and also for my actual family car, it's also a Volkswagen brand, I waited 10 months. Yeah, so, and if you want to buy some special cars, like an electric car, like your Tesla in the US, we've got some electric cars here from Hyundai and Kia, and also from Volkswagen, and you have to wait 1 year or longer. So that's the main difference, and it's also nice if you ordered your car, you can save your money a few months take your car from the dealer. And yeah, so okay, I want to show you right now the different models we've got in Germany. I've shown the internet on Ford US that you have also the Fiesta, the Focus, the Fusion, the C-Max, the Mustang, the Taurus, and so on. And let's start with the smallest one you can get in Germany. It's a Ford car. It's under the Ford Fiesta. It's an economy car. You can't buy it in the US. I think you can get it in Europe, because in Europe the cars are mostly, or the driver wants mostly, not so huge cars like in the US. So that's a reason why you can just get the smallest car here from Ford. It's an economy car. Yeah, when I use the classification from the rent cars, I know in the US it's an economy car. So the next will be the Fiesta. Let me show you, or let's find together a Fiesta. I don't know where I can find one. Is it here? That could be a Fiesta. It's a Ford Fiesta. Yes, it's a Fiesta. You know it also from the US. You can get it. But I've seen on the internet you can also get it as a sedan in Germany, with a Kofferraum, with a trunk. So you can't get a sedan in Germany. It's only hatchback. Yeah, so in Germany, Fließheck. But I think you know that kind of car. And that brings me to the next one. It's a Focus, the Ford Focus. Here is a station wagon version. You can get it also as a hatchback. And I don't know exactly that you can also get it as a sedan in Germany. The next one, the next size above from the Fiesta, is in Germany, the Mondeo. You don't know the car in the US, but I've seen, let's have a look. You have the Taurus and the Fusion. I don't know exactly what kind of these cars, what size they have. We can't buy the Taurus and the Fusion. We can buy the Ford Mondeo. It's a four-door family car. It's in Germany, it's full size. Yeah, it's a full size limousine, and the biggest limousine you can get from Ford in Germany. Yeah, so that's a class above the Focus. It's a Mondeo. You can get it also as a station wagon. I've got no station wagon here at this dealer today. So the next one I've seen on the internet is the SUV class. Okay, let's start with the SUV class. As the little ones, you can buy the EcoSport. Yeah, I know you can also buy the EcoSport in the US. I think it's a world car. I think it's coming up from, it's manufactured in India, when I'm right. The EcoSport is the smallest SUV you can buy from the Ford brand in Germany. And the next one is in the US, the Escape. We can't buy the Ford Escape, but we can buy the Kuga, and I think it's the same car. I have to look where it is here on the parking lot. That's a parking lot from the dealer. So yeah, that's the Kuga. I think it's also a world car. I don't know exactly, but I think the Kuga is known as the Ford Escape in US. The people in Germany like the Kuga. It's a class like it's mid-size. We call it mid-size SUV. I think for you it's a compact SUV, and that's the biggest SUV German brand you can buy in Germany. But since 1 year you can also buy the Ford Edge. You know the Ford Edge? I think it's manufactured in Canada, and it's the biggest SUV here from Ford since 1 year you can buy in Germany. But there's a little difference. You can get also diesel engines. I think you can get two different diesel engines, one with a normal gearbox, shifting gearbox, and one with automatic transmission. When I'm right, or when I got the right information. Yes, and that's all. And you can get also, as a second US model, the Ford Mustang. I haven't a Mustang here right now. It's very rare. It's beside the Edge. the second original US model you can drive in, or you can buy in Germany. Let's have a look. Oh, this is a second brand of the dealer. It's a Citroën, it's a European brand. It's a French car. It looks nice. It's a little bit younger style and looks a bit crazy, maybe like the Kia Soul, you know. It's a second brand here from that dealer. So let's have a look. Do I have a Mustang? No, that's no Mustang. What that? It's a Jaguar. Oh no. Okay, no Mustang here on this parking lot. Okay, I think that's all for today. And I've got a little notes here. I've also seen on the internet that you can buy also other models in addition, like the Transit Connect. I think the Transit Connect is also available in Germany for some transporting some, I have a look, is one here? No, for transporting some things. It's a little van. And I've seen also that you can buy a Ford Flex, a Ford Explorer, a Ford Expedition, a Ford Ranger, a F-150, and the 650-70, and the Super Duty. This kind of cars you can't buy in Germany. Only by own import, if you want. There are some special dealers, they are importing these cars for you if you want. But then they have, like the VIC, an US specification, and it's a little bit tricky to find a dealer. So this Ford dealer, when I get in trouble with my VIC, maybe it's 10 minutes from my house or my driveway, I think I will ask him. But they have only four-cylinder engines here in the German cars, and I don't know if they can help me. But it could be a way to ask them here. So as a conclusion, you have more Ford models here. Oh, let me show you the nice background here with the Ford sign. Okay, and you have nice Ford models like Fiesta, Focus, Fusion, C-Max. Oh, also the C-Max we can get in Germany, but I've read last week or last month they decided to produce them no more. So I think they sell it not so in numbers, in many numbers, so they want to stop the production of the C-Max. You have also the Mustang, the Taurus, the EcoSport, yeah, the Escape, the Edge, and the other ones I've told you. So I think 60% or 70% of the Ford models from the US you can get also in Germany, sometimes with another name, like the Escape, it's a Kuga in Germany, or like the other one was a Mondeo called in Germany, maybe it's a Fusion or the Taurus, I don't know it anymore, or I don't know it exactly. So thanks for watching, thanks for your time. I hope it was a little bit interesting in this cold winter November day here, and I want to produce no more videos this year, the reason I told you at the beginning of this video. And my own VIC is in a winter storage right now until end of April, and I will be back with new information, new videos next year. And thanks again for watching and for subscribing my channel. And if you want to know more, and if you want to be informed when I've got new information, you can click the bell button also, and then you get information when I'm on air again. So sorry for my ugly hat today, but it's really cold. Thanks for watching, and until next time, bye bye from Frank.